Hello everyone, I hope you all are staying safe and taking good care of yourselves. Today we are going to learn about sharing our responsibilities in a very creative and innovative way. We will see how to share our responsibilities in the form of a story, through various facts and a few very interesting activities. Let's get started. It was a lazy Sunday morning and Sana sat there on the sofa, staring at the wall, wondering what she could do. Her mother walked into the room and said, "Good morning, Sana. I saw that you were reading a book on lions yesterday. Tell me something about that book." Sana replied, "I read a few interesting facts, but if I were a lion, I do not want to be a lioness." Her mother was very confused and asked her, "Why do you say that, Sana?" "So when I was reading about the lions and the facts, I read that a lioness does the hunting, but the lion has the first right to eat the kill. Why is that? It is so unfair. Aren't they supposed to share their responsibilities?" The mother replied, "That might be true, but let me tell you about other animals and how they share their responsibilities. Let me tell you something interesting about emperor penguins. Female emperor penguins lay a single egg and leave for a hunting trip while the father penguin balances the egg on his feet to keep the egg warm. The father penguin does this for 2 months and he does this without food and water because he cannot leave the egg on an icy floor without any warmth. Mommy Pingu returns when egg hatches and then the father leaves in search of food. This is also sharing of responsibility, right? Now let me show you a short video of an egg hatching."
His egg has started to hatch. The father cared for this bundle of life for 2 whole months while his partner was out at sea. He hasn't fed. His only concern has been the egg's survival.
Sana's mother explained that it is all about how we look at things. And she explained that it is not necessary that only one person shares the responsibility. Another example she wanted to give is of a hornbill. Sana's brother, Sikandar, also came and sat with her with keen interest to listen to more facts. Sana's mother explained, "Hornbill males are an excellent example of distribution and sharing of responsibility. He takes trips every day to bring food for the babies and the mommy bird. That is a lot of work, don't you think so?" Now let's learn what responsibility is in the form of a short poem. "I can do things on my own. When I turn it on, I can turn it off. When I unlock something, I can lock it too. I can do things on my own. When I drop something, I pick it up and clean up after myself. I can do things on my own. When I make a promise, I will keep up my promise. I can do things on my own. When I find something, I return it. When I borrow something, I return it. I can do things on my own." Sana's mother then added, "Let us not forget your father. He helps around the house too. He prepares breakfast for us every morning, takes care of laundry and so many other tasks." Sikandar replied, "And I help with all the cuteness in the house." Sana and her mother both had a good laugh. Sana and Sikandar looked at each other and they said, "Mom, we want to start helping too. How can we help?" In the 6 petals of this flower, fill in the responsibilities and tasks that Sana and Sikandar can share at home. We have a few more interesting activities after this. I hope you all enjoyed learning about sharing responsibilities through a story, facts, short poem, and fun activities. Take care of yourselves and stay safe.